I'm going to be dead in a few hours. Your secrets couldn't be safer.
Unless you're keeping them from yourself.
I was deluded into thinking I might be crazy.
But you had been abusing Vicodin for years. Never had delusions, never had trouble sleeping, never had any problems other than narcissism and antisocial behavior until two colleagues died. Your father died. Your issues run deeper than Vicodin.
I like being alone. At least I convinced myself that I'm better off that way. And then I met someone in a psychiatric hospital, of all places. She changed me. And she left. And I'm lost.
You got hurt, which means you connected to someone else strongly enough to miss them. And more important, you recognized the pain and came to talk to me instead of hiding from it in the Vicodin bottle.
Has anything terrible ever happened to you?
What do you want me to say?
You wanted this conversation. You wanted to talk about something that matters.
Your actions here are all that matters.
Then nothing matters. There's no ultimate consequences.
Everything that happened to you can be rationally explained.
And that's a lot of coincidences.
This man, you're eager to pay homage to.
I did.
He loved doing what he did. He saw his work as some kind of sacred calling.
Back for either of you.
But I am what I am because of him. For better or for worse.
No, that's not what happened. I told you that I needed you. You helped me.
Are you okay? So?
I'm not okay.
This is the story you made up about who you are. It's a nice one.
Too bad it isn't true.
We're not friends anymore.
What do you have in your life? Honestly, tell me.
I'm not sure we ever were.
We've got nothing, House. Nothing.
I'm so sorry.
Today we're here to congratulate Greg. We wish him well, and we hope to
never see him again.
I don't want to be in pain. I don't want to be miserable. I'm dead, Wilson. Spend your last 5 months.